I'm gonna lean her towards you and I'm doing the Sunnis. Yeah?
Wow. The first piece of completed artwork I've ever produced. I was in an undergrad school and at lunchtime I would go for long walks in the woods. Up until that point I had felt an incompleteness. It's like I didn't fit anywhere, belong anywhere, I didn't do anything very well. I was coexisting in the universe, and I knew it. So when I got to the woods, there was this large lake. I would walk around the lake, and then I'd come back to school, and there was this log on the ground, and it just talked to me. I bent down, picked it up, put it on my shoulder, and walked about 2 or 3 miles back to school. The closer you get to the completion of a piece, the longer the time, the slower the process. And you can't rush it. Because what you want to happen is when you're looking at this piece, it has a fluidity to the eye that it moves through the piece without any interruptions or abrupt disconnections. In order to achieve that, you have to resolve any imperfections or irregularities in the piece, and the only way that that can happen is you just take your time. This is the labor part. And there's nothing romantic about it. Especially our visual heritage. And that a people without a visual heritage were really lost. This is about music and rhythmic patterns, to follow those graceful lines is listening to Keith Jarrett off of Waldixon. But as this piece comes through, swelling, expanding, shrinking, bulging, dipping, we come to this line that completes the piece, so the eye comes down here. So this is the point where these two sides converge, and there should be a delineation and sharpness that the eye can follow to bring the visual experience to some conclusion before you either walk away and disengage the piece or start all over, embracing the piece with your eyes. Through the whole fabric of your life, there is this relationship with your creator. Mm-hmm. Even when you're in violation of his will. there's still this persistent relationship because you're measuring yourself based on what he's already instructed you to do, what he wants you to do. And now you have the responsibility to communicate to him even when you screw up, even when you deliberately screw up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even when you say, I know what you want from me, Father, but I want to do this. And I had to knock down the barriers that would keep my speech and my mind confined and find new ways to say things. And then I found out that that fascinated people
mm-hmm.
because they hadn't heard, you know, somebody express that in that particular way or use the vocabulary that was unique,
right?
You know, in talking about maybe things that occur every day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I just never stopped having a passion for communicating.